Wow, how cool was that start? Hello, everybody. My name's Luke Diebold, and I'm going to be doing a talk on Quasar app extensions. So I'm ridiculously excited. There's so much stuff that I want to show you. So let me just see if I can quickly remove myself into it. So in this talk, we're going to be scaffolding out a gorgeous app with full authentication in under 3 minutes. Oh, it looks like it wants my webcam there. Can I get rid of that? See if we can make this full screen. If it doesn't work, that's totally fine. We'll leave it there.
Unfortunately, you're not able to. Oh, let me get you back in, Luke.
All right, that's totally fine. We can leave me on the side.
Good. Unfortunately, we don't have any other options, so take it away.
No, that's totally fine. So we're going to scaffold a gorgeous app with full authentication in under 3 minutes. I think you guys are really going to love that. We're also going to marry Vue and Superbase with an API that'll rock your world. And then we're going to craft a to-do app with Quasar's gorgeous component library. Now, quick disclaimer, I am going to be using an experimental package, which is the kind of Vue Superbase package. So I wouldn't be using that in production just yet. And the other thing is I'm going to be moving fast. There's lots of cool stuff I want to share, but I figured some people like to have those kind of action-packed, high-intensity talks. So that's going to be sort of my target audience. Otherwise, just sort of let this talk flow over you. And I want you to just get an idea and a feel for what it's like working with Quasar app extensions. All right. So without further ado, let's scaffold a gorgeous app with full authentication in under 3 minutes. First of all, I'm going to say Quasar extension add, and it's going to be called vueauth/auth. So this is Quasar's auth app extension that I've been working on. And we're going to be using Superbase behind the scenes here. So just wanted to quickly show you the to-do list table that we're working with. And it's got a user ID so that the user can be identified for that to-do and also the body and whether or not it's completed. All right, so let's jump over to settings here and then we'll go to API. And notice that we've got this anon key and the URL. They're the two bits of information we're going to need to set up authentication. All right, so now it's going to say, hey, do we want to use Laravel, Sanctum, Firebase, or Superbase? And we're going to be adding more auth providers in the future. We're going to be using Superbase in this video. So now if I go over to the config, Superbase, we can start plugging in those credentials I was showing you before. So we'll go up here, grab that API key, whack it in here. That's the Superbase key. And then also the URL. So we'll grab this URL and we will whack it in there like that. Simple as that. Now, when that's done, we can run Quasar dev to start our dev server. And while that's running, I just want to quickly show you here. If we go to the source directory, underneath auth, that's where all of our files were created for us. So we can just come in here and edit them to our heart's content. So for example, we can go to components and go into the login card and then just start configuring your login card there. All right, so let's throw that to the side and we'll throw our browser to the side here so we can get into development mode. I have to run Quasar dev again. Give that a second to run. And then when it's done, we'll open it up here in the browser and we'll start playing around with this card. But nearly done. There we go. So we'll jump into localhost. There it is. And if I jump to the login page now, we get this login page for free. This is what the app extension has given us. And I can say, for example, hey, I want you to make this card flat. And that's going to get rid of the shadow there. Maybe you want that border back in so you can make it bordered. Add that border back in. Maybe you want to change the color of this button. We can just come down here. And basically, you've got the full power of Quasar at your fingertips now. Really cool. And this signing form works. It's fully hooked up to Superbase from when we entered our app credentials. Now, another thing we've got is forgot password. That's going to work. We've got a register page built for us. And of course, if I say luke@quasarcast.com and log in there, we can log in as well. Super, super cool. So that's how we were able to scaffold a gorgeous app with full authentication in under 3 minutes. It's super easy with Quasar. Now, one more thing that I do quickly want to show you is redirects. So if I go to the login page now, then that's going to work, but it shouldn't because I'm already logged in. So we've already handled that for you as well. If we go to source and then we go to app.view, we can basically say import authenticate routes. Okay, this is a special function that's going to authenticate our routes for us from at vueauth/quasar-ui-auth. And then all we have to do is call that function in here, save it, and notice that I was redirected back to the dashboard. So I'll show that again. If we try and go to the login page now, it sends us right back to the dashboard. All right, so moving on to the next thing, marrying Vue and Supabase with an API that'll rock your world. And to do this, we're going to be using an app extension for VueXORM. And VueXORM is, you know what, I'll start getting it installed first, and then I'll run over what it is. Shut down the server, Quasar extension, add VueX-ORM. And we'll jump over to our user dashboard here. And I got there by going to Pages, User Dashboard. And so you can think of VueXORM as kind of like it's kind of like Vuex, but using models. So it's like this layer on top of Vuex that allows you to very easily insert models, update them, delete them, and also deal and query models so that you can get related data. And I'll give you a quick idea of what the API looks like. So you might say, for example, import to do from models slash to do. And let's actually go ahead and create that. And by the way, app extensions allow you to create your own commands as well. So we can say, hey, Quasar, using the extension Vuex-ORM, I want you to create a new model, and let's call that model to do. Have I done something wrong there? I'm going to try copy-pasting it with my cheat code here just in case I've done something wrong. There we go. I probably typed that wrong. Now, notice that Vuex-ORM, this app extension, gave us this models directory here. And there we go. It's gone ahead and created that to-do file for us, that to-do model. However, then we need to go ahead and import the model and so that it's actually going to be inserted into the store and ready to accept data. So this app extension actually gave us a file to make that super easily. If we go to our store, index.js, we don't need modules, so we'll get rid of that, change it to plugins, give that an array. We can say here, Quasar VueXORM plugin. So that's this plugin here, and that was given to us with the app extension. And this gives us a little bit of Webpack magic. So it basically says, hey, I'm going to look at all the models in this directory and automatically put them into the store for you. So check this out. If I go into full screen now, open up the console, jump into Vue. We're going to have to actually run Quasar Dev again. And actually, while that's running, let's jump to todo.js. And I'll show you how you can add fields with VueXORM. This is all going to make sense and sort of wrap up later on in this video. So if we say body, we can say this.string is equal to an empty string by default. And then we can say, for example, completed is equal to this.boolean. And we'll make that false by default. All right, so this is loaded now. And notice it's automatically inserted to do and users into the store for us. And this users one is basically one that we get for free because most applications will have a user. But you can go ahead and delete it if you need to. All right, so there we go. We're ready to start accepting data with VueXORM. Let's go back to the user dashboard. And let me just give you a quick rundown of the API. You can do stuff like insert. You can do updating for updating data, deleting data. And that's going to allow you to do all of those actions inside of your state. So let's just do a quick insert to demonstrate this. The data that we're going to give it is an array of data. It's going to have an ID of 1. And let's give it a body equal to go shopping. And as was mentioned before, I have two beautiful chihuahuas. So I'm going to say here, walk dogs. And change that to an ID of 2. Save it. And then in order to get that data back, let's just change this H3 into some data and we'll wrap that in a pre-tag. And then we can just basically spit it out here by saying to do.or. So there's just a quick example of how easy it is to start dealing with data when you're using VueXORM. However, for me, this kind of raised a problem of, well, how do I then marry VueXORM? So how do I marry my state, my front-end data with super based on the back end and the extension that makes it really easy, that gives me some composables that makes it really easy to do that. So check this out. We're going to come over to the left panel here and say Quasar extension add, and this one is called at view model slash superbase. So this Superbase app extension deals with that dance between front-end and back-end data. So for example, if I want to index some to-dos, it'll go to the backend, get the to-dos, and it'll handle inserting that data into the store for me. So there might be some situations where you don't want to do that because you need like super fine-grained control, but most of the time, this stuff is the same. Creating data, you usually want to then insert it into the store. Updating data, you usually then want to update it into the store. And basically, this is going to do all that for you. So check this out. I can now say import use model collection. Actually, I should get auto import here. Let's go ahead and check if that works. We'll get rid of that and say use model collection. No, I did not. So import use model collection, and that's going to be coming from at view model slash superbase. Now let's just have a quick look at what we've got available here. We've got the collection itself. So once it's actually fetched the data, we can then look at it with that collection. We've also got here index. So we can call this function and that performs that action of fetching the data and putting it into the store. And we can see whether or not we're indexing. So we can do some loading state. So check this out, let's use it. If we come in here and we say, let's start with index and also the collection, and we can assign collection to to-dos. Let's try that. We'll come up here and we'll call index straight away. And then we'll just spit out our to-dos once we've got them. So let's do that and save it. Give it a second. Did I run the dev server? Of course I didn't. But while that's running, we can do something else. Let's come in here and then say indexing. And then we can say here, Q-spinner. So Quasar's got a really nice spinner component. We'll set the size equal to large, and then we'll give it a color equal to primary. And then we can say here, indexing. Oh, we'll say loading. Oh, sorry, V-if. So if it is indexing, then I want you to show this spinner. And there we go. How cool is that? This data is coming from the backend and it's being inserted for us. And look at this API. Index, we've got the to-dos and indexing. We just pull it directly out of the composable and it all just works. And you might want to display it like this. This might be a nicer way to format it. But then you can easily just like add to the list of things that you want to do out of use model collection. And I'll quickly refresh it again. You probably can't see that loading state because it happens so quickly, but it is actually working there. All right, so the next thing I'm going to do is a create button. So we can come in here and say use model API. And then I can say here, for example, const, and we're going to pluck create and whether or not it is creating out of use model API. And then we're going to pass that to do. Now, check this out. We can say here, Q-page-sticky. So this is a Quasar component that allows you to stick something on the page. So you can put it in like the bottom right-hand corner of the page or the top middle, wherever you like. So we can say here, for example, now position is equal to bottom right to basically throw a button down here. That's going to be our create button. And let's give it an offset as well. And we'll make that equal to an array that's equal to 2222. Quasar makes this stuff so easy. And then let's just do a blank Q button to see if that's working. Oh, I then need to actually use create and creating for it to actually work. Otherwise, my linter squawks at me. So let's say loading is equal to creating. And then at click is equal to create. Save it. Get a second to load. And there we go. We have a create button that just works. How cool is that? And now I can say, for example, FAB, that's going to make it a floating action button. Let's give it a color equal to maybe accent. That's probably a good color to have here. And let's give it an icon as well, equal to add. There we go. We got this really nice floating action button that works. And it's setting the body to null. So what we could do is give create an object and say the body is equal to an empty string by default. There we go. Now, the last thing that I want to do in this video is actually use Quasar's component library, start crafting a to-do app that just looks really, really nice by default without any extra work. So check this out. If I come in here and then say, instead of to-dos, a Q-list, and inside of that list, we'll have all of our to-dos. So we'll have a new component for that called to-do item. And what are we going to give that to-do item? How about we give it We'll say v-4 is equal to to-do in to-dos. Remember, those to-dos are already being fetched from the backend here with index and then assigned here with use model collection. So to-do in to-dos, we can say the key is equal to to-do.id. We can then say the to-do is going to be the current to-do that we're iterating over. So let's go ahead and now create this component. New file, to-do item.view, and this is going to be, let's give it a blank template. And then we can just say, for example, q-item. And then inside of there, we'll have a q-item-section. By default, we're just going to spit out the to-do dot body just to check if everything is working. So define props here. We want to accept that to-do that we passed through. Yes, it is required. And I want the type to be equal to a to-do. All right. Hopefully I did everything right. Let's go ahead and import that. By the way, how amazing is Volar? The fact that if it isn't imported, it's going to come up in red. I think that's just really cool. Super nifty. And there we go. All of my to-dos are there. And it just works. So let's get rid of all of this styling here on the page. And I might make this list full width. Class is equal to full width. Quasar has an awesome utility library that we get by default. So we can do stuff like that and also changing the layout, all that kind of good stuff. And now we can jump into this to-do item and start playing around with it. All right. So next, we'll just do the styling for everything first. So item-section. And inside of there, how about we have a delete button? So q-button. And then we can give this an icon equal to delete. And we'll make it flat. How about we make it round? Let's see what that looks like so far. And I'm going to tell this item section to be on the side. So if I don't put side there, it basically sort of pulls everything out. But if you say side, it's automatically going to make sure that this item is put to the side. I want that smaller, so we'll make the size equal to small. And I think that looks pretty good now. The other thing that we're going to need is a checkbox button. So let's say here, q-checkbox. And by default, we'll just say model-value is equal to to-do.completed to see if that's working. And there we go. It works. So we were able to style this very quickly using Quasar. And man, I wish I had time to show you Quasar's component library, but it would literally take me days because it's so there's so much breadth and awesomeness to their API. Anyway, I digress. The next thing we want to do is use model, which is a composable that allows us to deal with this model in some interesting ways. Check this out. So we're going to import use model, and that's going to be coming from at view model slash superbase. And we also going to be using watch effect here. So let's go ahead and get that imported now. Watch effect from view. Now, if I come down here, I can say use model and give you a quick rundown of the API here. Notice that it gives us a form for free. Now, this is awesome. Since it knows what the to-do looks like, it can automatically create a form for us. And then we can use that form, change it around. And then when the form is being changed, if we've set the ID as well, so it knows the to-do that it's working with, we can then call update. So check this out. If we say const, and we're going to pull some things out of use model. And what are we going to pull out? We'll pull out the form I was just talking about. We'll pull out update so we can actually update it when we've changed the data. We'll pull out updating so we can have a loading spinner that shows that it's updating. And we also need the ID so that it knows what to update. So now what I can do is say we'll use watch effect here. And then we're going to have to set define props, set that equal to props. And now basically we can make sure that the to-do's ID is in sync with the ID that we've got here on use model. So we'll say id.value is equal to props.to-do.id. So they're going to be in sync. Now here we can add in a form. So let's say q-input, very quick way to make a form, v-model is equal to form.body. Once again, that form has already been built for us. We save it. It's going to want us to use the other stuff we've got here. Maybe I can just comment that out for now. Give it a second. And there we go. Now we've got a form. But of course, when I update, it doesn't actually update on the back end. But all I have to do now is say at blur, for example, or however you want to have an action for the update, just call update. it already knows about the form, so we can just call update directly there. So we could say eat lettuce and tomato, and then refresh the page. And that was not updated. What have I done wrong here? And tomato. I'll unfocus. And we'll quickly jump into our console here. Update is not a function. That's because I commented out like a ninny face. So there we go. Let's say eat lettuce and tomato. And then we'll refresh the page. And it works. How cool is that? We've also got updating. So we can come in here and then Quasar gives us the ability to add in a loading state, and we'll set that equal to up. I just want to show you what that looks like first. So we'll set it to true. And notice that it gives us a spinner here. And we can just say updating. And then say eat lettuce. And notice that we get a spinner here. It's going to go super fast. You could barely see it because it's too quick. All right, let's move on to the next one. Removing an item. This is ridiculously simple. We pluck out remove, we pluck out removing, we come down here, and then we say, when you click on remove, I want you to remove it. And let's say that the loading state is going to be equal to removing. Quasar makes this so easy. All of this is available for us by default. So now I can just delete these, and it works. How cool is that? And then also this checkbox here, we can say, for example, form.completed instead. And then what I'm going to do is I'll just do this inline for now. We can say at update model dash value is equal to, and that's going to accept what it's been toggled to. So we can then come down here and then say form.completed. Once again, that form has already been built for us, is equal to completed. And then we just call update. Save it. Now let's refresh the page. And there we go. Let's untick all of those. And it just worked. How unbelievably cool is that? One last thing I'm going to do before finishing up my talk here is add borderless and maybe make this dense as well. So it takes up some less space. Yeah, I think that looks a bit better. Go shopping for food. And there we go. That's how we were able to craft a to-do app with Quasar's gorgeous component library. Now, one quick thing I want to say, if you don't like the way I develop, that's totally fine. If you thought some of the stuff I'm doing is sacrilegious, that's totally fine. Basically, I'm showing you that with Quasar app extensions, you can start streamlining your day-to-day tasks and start building things really fast, but not just fast. You can build it in a robust way because Quasar app extensions are so ridiculously flexible. So I hope you enjoyed my talk. Check out quasarcast.com if you want to watch more videos and see the kind of stuff that I'm doing. Quasar View Life is a podcast. You can look that up on the on your podcatcher of choice if you want to follow my story. And there's my Twitter handle there, @LukeDiebold. There we go. Hope you enjoyed my talk.